Hey y'all.
Hey y'all. Howdy.
Welcome to episode 7 of Rusty Knits.
And now Hampton does too.
Well, I'm starting to learn.
He is. Are you going to be showing him?
Nope.
Oh.
Because I'm not much further along than I was on the last episode.
He's picked it up a few times.
Yeah. I have.
Yeah.
I just don't have as much time to do it as you do.
Right. I know. Oh. Bye, kitty.
All right. Let's focus here. Let the cats take care of
there's
themselves.
There's lots going on here.
Yes, there's
it's late.
Always.
We don't usually do it this late. It's, oh no, it's August 12th. I thought it was 8/12.
It is.
It's 8/12 and it's.
It is.
What's
and it's hot today. I went and got groceries after I finished working. It was 104 Fahrenheit. What's that? 40 degrees Celsius is hot.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of worn out from it.
Yeah.
It's it takes a lot out of you. I mean, the car is air conditioned. The store is air conditioned. It's air conditioned inside the house, but it's just lugging the groceries from the car back in. Anyway.
I was going to wear my green glasses. I'm sitting here looking at our new shirts, and I should have green glasses on.
Well, you don't.
I don't.
So...
Good.
So today we're going to be talking about, we took some more field trips.
Yes, that seems to be our thing. We'll probably be doing more of that.
Well, you know, it's fun exploring the knitting, yarn, and fiber stores around the city. Now that we've realized there are quite a few, but they are spread far and yon. And so it's like little day trips, and it gives us something to, a reason to get out of the house. And And generally, when we show up at the knit stores, the knitting stores, there's not too many people there.
Yeah, there's very few. So
it's easier than going to the grocery store or
except
the Target.
Well, we'll have a little story about that.
Yeah, we will. And then we also have our new acquisitions to show because we did pick up some things at the stores. And did you get anything in the mail this week? Any yarns in the mail?
No,
not
should
this,
I?
Not in the past couple weeks. No, I'm just saying.
Oh,
a lot of times that's the way you get your yarn.
Yeah, no.
So you're all set up for your artwork, okay?
I'm set up for my artwork with Lolo Did It and Round Table Yarns.
Okay.
And I'm there's some other dyers that I kind of am anxious to buy some yarn, but I really need to use some of the yarn I have.
Sure.
Imagine that.
And then we also have some finished objects to show y'all.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a little video to show y'all. This past Sunday, we worked in the garden, our patio garden. Mm-hmm. And,
and
Rusty has been growing, since we've lived here for 5 years, he's been growing mainly cactus and succulents. And so that's why we have the shirts. And some people know Rusty, or some people call Rusty Popeye Cacti because
Poppy Cacti
because he if you got a question about how do you raise these succulents, am I giving it too much water, or am I when do I split them up, that kind of thing, just ask Rusty. He'll tell you.
A few years ago, I really got into succulents. Was it 5 years ago? About.
Yeah.
And when we moved into this place, everything was being remodeled. And, you know, we haven't even talked about our new setup here. However, we'll get back to that. I'm sure you'll notice we're just facing the other side of the room.
Same room.
But 5 years ago, this whole place was being remodeled. Not this room. This is the most recent. But the room that I like to spend the most time in was outside on the front patio. We hadn't had a garden. We hadn't even had windows where we used to live.
No, we had one clear story. They gave us some light. It was interesting. I didn't think I'd ever be able to live someplace with no windows. But we were there for 11 years.
I kind of liked it. Even back then, I was trying to practice social distancing.
So. Yeah, you like to be alone. You're a hermit.
Yeah. But every now and then someone would walk on the roof to do maintenance, and all of a sudden they're, because you set everything up under that one window, and so all of then that's really an invasion when someone walks and is looking down on you.
Okay.
It is.
But anyway, and then we will get to comments and feedback and have our show.
Yeah.
So we're going to try to keep this to an hour this time. But we'll see what happens.
We'll see.
So first off, we took our trip to McKinney and Bonham.
Right.
Which are, let's see, what was McKinney was about, I think, 30 miles from here. And then Bonham was another 30-ish miles northeast of McKinney. So we're kind of going around the Metroplex in places that we can get to and back home in a day.
Yeah.
Because you got to get back home and feed the cats.
Always.
Always. because we also don't want to leave them to the neighbors to take care of them all the time. It'd be nice to go and get a hotel room sometime. And
I haven't figured out the cats yet because some of them are indoors and outdoors, and one of them is feline leukemia, and I'm keeping him always outside, but he's fighting with the possums. It's a complicated, like I've said before, and sometime I will show that. But it's complicated, and I'm afraid to leave him.
We have a relationship with cats, and it's complicated.
Yes.
So,
anyway, we make day trips,
and it's just been fun to get out of the house. So we went to McKinney, and that was it. McKinney
that
is another
awesome
little historic town with historic town square with a courthouse.
Is this historic downtown?
Well, we're kidding.
Green. Historic. Not yet. But I can feel the history building. The McKinney Knittery.
The McKinney Knittery is where we went first.
And it was a little difficult because they're doing street repairs.
Yeah, street and sidewalk repair right out front.
And so even though people were wearing masks and groups of people were distanced, we still had to cross like a bridge, a couple walkways on plywood, like a plywood bridge, over the street. And you had to pass by people, and so I was ducking away and being really obviously.
Yeah, because they did have a wine crawl going on afternoon when we showed up. The store was supposed to, normal hours was it was closing at 4, I think.
Drinking doesn't help people social distance.
We made it there at 3:30, but turns out they were staying open late till 7 because it was a wine crawl. And I guess there were other places in downtown McKinney that were having wine. And so luckily they were kind of all on one side of the store, up in one corner of the store. So
in the front.
Yeah, but by the front, you had to come through the front door.
And they were creating a long line. There must have been 15 people in line waiting for wine and then gathering around.
But they would come and go.
Yep.
But they were, a lot of them were making sales too, mm-hmm. because they were, while they were there drinking their wine, they were looking at yarn and fabrics, and they were buying them.
the owners were
just like we were.
I think they were the owners were really aware of there's
twice they were as keeping many account.
There's twice as many people as should be here, but they the group was separate. It's like I didn't know how to deal with it.
I heard the woman ask the man. She goes, "Are we okay? Are there too many people? Looks like a lot of people." He said, "No, I'm keeping count. We're right at the right number. We're doing okay." So that happened.
At one point, it was twice what it should be.
Well, I don't know what the number was supposed to be. We don't know. But we were there, and we stayed off
the knitting area, which was the bulk of the store. And yeah, it was a lot of knitting. We should be talking about the yarn, because
yes,
I loved this knitting store.
Because I think actually our videos don't even show a lot of other people, so they look like
I'll show you what we've got. Yeah. But this store was awesome.
It was very awesome.
There was just so much to take in, so much beautiful, beautiful yarn. Mm-hmm. And it was just, I'm not sure what to say about it. They were very helpful. I went and asked him for a mohair, a lace mohair, because I'm doing a new project, or I did a new project, which I'll show you.
Yeah, well, another knit along, you did that.
But they had about five different areas where I had choices of colorways, and it was anyway, I can't wait to show some of the video, because it was awesome.
So that's good. I love the red.
And then from there, we drove on up to Bonham, Texas, which is northeast of McKinney. I guess it's basically part of the DFW Metroplex, but it is quite rural.
It's about an hour north of Dallas. Because it took 60 or 70 minutes to get home.
Yeah, it did. It did, because it was out there. Once we left McKinney, we were in the country. Mm-hmm. We were in the country. And I think you have some driving shots from doing that mm-hmm. you'll intersperse throughout the video podcast.
Every now and then I would set my knitting down. And one thing that's not on our list, so I'll just throw it in right now, I did get webcam glasses. No one would suspect that they're not real glasses.
Oh. You're going to be a spy now.
Yeah, so.
It's your new job.
I can infiltrate things.
Those are attractive.
That's why I feel like a scientist. A knitting scientist.
You're a knitting nerd.
So anyway, you might see some of that.
He is a knitting nerd. But yeah, those are cool. They would take, and you've all seen some of the video from that on the introduction where he's knitting some socks on the patio.
Yeah, I had a pair of these glasses.
That we've been using that introduction for a while.
I had a pair of the glasses, and then they stopped. Well, it started playing it like three times. The audio played at the right speed, but the video played three times too fast. And it looked in the little instruction manual if you're having problem with video playback, format the disc? And so I said, yes, format, because I didn't have anything on there to save. Well, then it made it so my computer wouldn't recognize it and they couldn't help me. So I had to wait for a new pair of glasses.
Yep.
And they just came. So now I'm starting to use them and trying to insert some interesting scenes where I'm always knitting. It's like, close up. It would be
fun to show knitting
in front of what I'm actually looking at.
Right. So then we got to the store, and this one in Bonham is called the Cotton Mill. And Bonham is also a county seat, so it has a little courthouse right in the middle square. But it was under construction. It looked like they totally gutted the old courthouse and were rebuilding it. But to rebuilding it to look like it's old, or like it originally looked, I don't know. I've never been there before. I'd always heard of it. Now I've been to Bonham.
Mm-hmm.
So we did that.
Were they sisters?
Okay. Yes.
And yeah, that was really interesting because one of them did her teapot collection.
Yeah, it was actually the cotton mill is actually a yarn and tea shop. So they serve sandwiches throughout the day and cheesecake. They offered us some cheesecake. That's all they had left.
Oh, we were supposed
to
take it home. We were some of the last people, and I like cheesecake, and I
she told me that she offered it to you, that you said you didn't want any because we were still full.
Well,
from
at first I did, and I said, and I really didn't want sweets because I'm just.
You're not.
I eat enough.
You don't eat that.
Eat enough.
Okay. So that was at the cotton mill, and so it is a yarn store and a tea shop with all these collectible teapots. So what did I do? I had to add to my teapot collection.
And I just had to say, oh, Hampton collects teapots.
He just happened. And so then I was on the spot. And of course, I had to buy one then, didn't I? So I did, and it's right here.
They really got a range of them.
Oh, there it is. It's a Santa Claus.
Wait, there. It's backwards. Now I know why people have so much difficulty trying to do this backwards thing.
So it's
but we should show it.
It's
don't you want to show
I
it?
Don't want to pick it up.
I'll
and
show
move
a
it
picture.
Around.
I'll show it in the video because it's really cool.
Yeah.
It's Linux, right?
It's a Linux. It's Linux, yeah.
So he got a really good deal.
It was a really good price. Way cheaper than what it would have been new. But I don't know how old it is. But I didn't see any
and you've collected,
chips or anything.
You've collected Linux Nativity and rabbits. Hampton is a rabbit fiend.
Yes.
We used to have hundreds of rabbit sculptures around here.
But a lot of them weren't. Now I try to focus on art. Art rabbits and art teapots generally.
And
brooches. And socks.
And socks now. He slowed down with the socks because I'm expected to knit them for him now.
Yes. So we'll show you some of that. So you'll notice, in fact, you'll notice in these videos from McKinney and Bonham, I'm walking around. When you see me, I'm walking around. And those rainbow socks that I'm wearing are the ones that Rusty knit.
Yes. Yeah, those are my newest finished object, which you'll show.
Yeah, we'll be showing those. So, okay. And then that was on Saturday of last weekend. And then Sunday, we just went ahead and took another trip up to DMH Fiber and Yarns.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a nice chat with Denise and Heather. And you got some, well, we'll show that in acquisitions, but you got some funky little popcorn yarn.
I saw it the first time, and should we start showing?
No, well, we're about to.
Okay.
But before,
on the script.
Another reason I wanted to go up to DMH was because I had said something, probably, it was on Facebook, I think, where I said, I showed a picture of this crown, and then some of my friends, because I collect crowns and tiaras too. It's jewelry.
Tiara
what
Friday.
Can I say? It's Tiara
if,
Friday.
If someone
yeah.
hasn't seen that episode, we show what Tiara
we're gonna have
Friday
to film
is.
Some Friday sometime, and I'll do tiara. I'll wear tiaras.
Right. We could create a little animation around that.
Oh, we could. We'll have to put that in sometime.
Yeah.
There's always wine, though, with TR Friday, so...
Yeah, so look out.
Wine or beer.
Look
out.
You have
a choice.
We're refraining, believe it or not, this is us without any drinks. So...
We're not like... We don't have to have them all the time.
No, not most of the time, but...
No, not most of the time. But, I just have iced tea, and I think you've got water.
I've got water right now.
Mm. So, let's do move on to the acquisitions.
Starting with McKinney Knittery.
McKinney Knittery.
And so you got...
I got 4 skeins of yarn for you to make me some more socks.
This is where it starts.
Yes, so... Here is...
And watch out for the mic.
I'm watching out for the mic. This is 1952 Farmer's Daughter Fibers, made in Montana. This color is called Foxy Lady. Whatever, I'm fine with that.
Okay.
I can be gender
Hampton
fluid.
Approves.
You know, whatever. 70% merino, 30% silk, and there you go.
You know what? I don't know if this is going to
help. Oh, actually,
help.
The color is Shake-A-Day.
Okay.
Well, I can do that.
I'm going to do something in just a second. So here's the color. And someone suggested, and I'm going to have to look at my notes. I think it was Diana. Diana Thorpe said. And so I'm jumping ahead to comments.
Where
but I'm going to try with and without a white background. Because she said some podcasters will actually, it'll help color. Well, look at it, folk Hampton. Look at it, focus. Are you able
oh,
to see?
Oh, I see. Yeah. Uh-huh.
So now it's not as focused
on it. Oh, yeah,
it
was Diana Thorpe.
But I put the paper behind it, and it takes a sec. Come on.
Okay. Oh.
Well,
so
anyway.
Let me show the next one.
I can cut that out.
So the next one I got is a magpie. And where is that from? I don't know.
Well, it said, well, that's a tag.
Oh, you know what? It's got, oh, Magpie Fibers.
It says right under here.
Oh, it does.
Swanky sock.
Oh, hand-dyed in Frederick, Maryland, MD, Maryland.
Is that swanky sock too? Oh,
yeah.
It is.
So okay. I got this one. It's 80% merino, 10% cashmere, 10% nylon. And it's called Chronic, but it's Swanky Sock yarn by Magpie.
I love the colors.
I love those colors, too.
We have got our microphone working.
Yeah, we didn't know it
was
working.
We didn't know. We've had this big microphone in front of us for 6 episodes, and it was using the cheap one on the laptop.
Let me see this. Let me show that.
This is so... We both saw this when we walked in. And
it is actually the first
one.
It was
the first thing we both walked to out of this huge display.
This is the first one I picked up.
And I didn't. I had moved on by then, so I didn't see him pick it up. So I got it, too. Except, and the only way we can, and we discovered afterwards, that's what happened. The only difference is that I had mine wound up, luckily, because I wouldn't want to mix up our skeins that we individually picked
out. Right. There were,
Anyway, I think it's so pretty.
And this one is called Stars and Stones.
Stars and Stones?
Stars
okay.
and Stones. It's also 80% merino and 10% cashmere and 10% nylon.
Who was it that made the comment about you knitting? And just look out once you get into knitting and the stat. I mean, the lines are starting to blur already.
Starting to blur.
I don't know where this could lead.
It's your fault. It's your fault.
Well, we have the same taste after 20 years, 22 years.
Yeah. We even look alike now, too.
I love this one we talked about, but I think this is my favorite.
This.
Oh, my God.
Is gorgeous. It's called Chasing Rabbits. Can you see that on the camera?
Chasing... Oh, I'm hiding you, aren't I?
Chasing Rabbits Fiber Company. And this one is actually made in Amarillo, Texas. And this color is Crepe Myrtle Trail. And it is specially dyed for the McKinney Knittery.
And so
I saw this and I loved it. And I only have like maybe one pair of pink socks anyway. So this pink and green, I'm going to love that.
Yeah. Another project.
For you.
For me.
To do.
Which I'm quite happy with, but this will take a while because I'm working on my artwork. However,
yes.
The crepe myrtles here in Texas and probably all over the South are very popular. They really can take the 100 degree days. They can take the teens, I don't know how hardy, but they can easily take our single digits every now and then weather.
Right.
And I'm really proud because a couple years after we moved here, I got a cutting off of this one crepe myrtle that was growing outside of a bank.
Yeah.
And it in Uptown Dallas. And it had dark red flowers. And I just, the dark red ones were kind of new back then. And so I took a cutting and I rooted it and it actually bloomed.
You just took a cutting that was like 4 inches.
Yeah.
Nobody was ever going to miss that from the tree.
Right.
And you rooted it.
Yeah, I guess I did kind of take that. But I did it very, very artistically.
And well, of course you did.
And it's very happy. We planted it in an umbrella stand.
The tree seems to be growing better now.
We planted it in an umbrella stand, a tall ceramic one that we had inherited with this place.
Yes.
And so it's tall. It's almost 2.5 feet tall anyway. And then it starts up there. So it's really a tall plant already after a few years and really bloomed good this year.
Yeah, it did.
Oh, we showed a little video clip of it last time.
Oh, did we? Okay.
Yeah, a short, almost great. Not moving video of the patio.
Oh, yeah, that was right there, the white yarn. Okay. And then, so from the cotton mill, and we pointed this out, I got that Santa teapot. And then from DMH Fiber and Yarn, I did get that tiara that we were showing the video of just a little while ago of Denise putting the tiara on my head.
He just couldn't resist it. He's a
crown
size queen.
No, it doesn't fit.
No. Oh.
You do have a big head.
Well,
you can have try this one. This one's bigger.
And I don't have any hair to pin it to.
That's true.
I used to have this big old.
Oh, there we go.
That one really fits.
Yeah, I like that one.
That looks really good. Maybe that's not a good thing to say.
It's the biggest. It is the biggest one I've got. Look, see there. You know, there it is. Right there it is.
I know we barely fit in the picture. If we want to show that thing.
And it does fit on my big old man head.
It doesn't feel good. It's a circle, and that doesn't really fit. Most people have an oval head, but somehow there must be a cushion that maybe you could sew or something that would make it look regal and
well, maybe I could. You know, I got that cloth, that felt or velvet crown in Portland last year.
Oh, yeah, but that would take over the whole inside.
But it doesn't have jewels on it.
Okay, well, we can see.
We'll see. I'll try doing that sometime.
So then, we'll from, what did I get? Cotton mill. He got a teapot. I got stitch markers. I really didn't see any yarn. I had just gotten some yarn. I just got stitch markers.
Yeah, we had just bought yarn at the last store.
Oh, and this.
That's what happens when you go to two yarn stores in one day. Is it focusing?
It helps it focus.
Oh, it does.
Because.
Well, you got it really close now. The one is focusing.
They're elephants.
Oh.
I won't spread them out because they're really hard to see yet, or hard to get it to focus. And for some reason, I got pinup girls. Anyway, I usually knit, I'm the do-it-yourself kind of person. So I usually make stitch, I usually tie a loop of yarn and use that as my stitch markers and put up with the little threads, the spare threads getting in there. And but now I have legit stitch markers.
Yes. And then you at DMH Fiber and Yarn.
Okay.
And this was on sale too, so who can resist a sale?
Well, I didn't know it was on sale. I was willing to have Hampton pay full price for this.
Oh, that's right. I threw it in with my crown, and I was just like, oh, I'll buy that for you.
But it was Why on not? Sale, so who couldn't resist this for $4?
Right.
I just have no clue what I'm going to do with it. Okay, I'm not really getting better at this.
I think it'll be cute as a hat, in a hat.
I have a new blister from doing all that yard work.
Oh, I'm still finding those microscopic thorns in me.
But it's on lace yarn. It's on lace, like, thread. And then the pom-poms. And I have no clue what I'm going to do with it. Maybe you can knit it on a circle and give some kind of fringe effect on...
Yeah, probably.
And the edge, or a transition, or sweater when I finally...
I don't know if that's what I want on my sweater, though.
Oh, well, I can see it.
Well,
they would stand out against that almost black.
It might happen. Then that's okay. I do like yellow, and I do like green, so, you know. Do some cabling on my sweater and
fit that in there. I never showed what I got at the McKinney Knittery. Okay, so, well, first I got this, which was the same as Hampton's.
All right.
But then I got, so I did get my lace, and it's, this is already spun up. But, oh my gosh, I love this halo, this, it's really like gold. One more try.
And it is a lace weight, right?
It's a lace weight. Okay, well, this
but it's mohair.
Is not working.
And that's what you asked about when we
it's
went in
called,
there. You
it's
went
called
to
honey.
See.
It's gossamer, and it's called honey. And I think it's so pretty. And, well, I'll wait for my finished objects, but I actually used it. So.
Well.
I love that yarn.
Actually, we could start with finished objects. We can go on to finished objects now. And you could start with that.
I'll start with that.
Hat that. Used to do.
So this is the slipped rib hat by Jodi Brown on Ravelry, and you can see the longer slip stitches are this yarn from U2 yarn,
and that was in Waxahachie, right?
And then that's combined with this honey colored mohair, and so you're seeing the mohair in between the columns of slip stitches. And I just love that. And then this is a twisted one by one rib, twisted knit columns.
And I think you have a photograph you took in the car that you could put in here, because it really makes the fuzz show up in the sunlight.
Yeah.
The fuzz, the fur, that halo effect. It really is.
Oh, there,
beautiful.
I got it to focus. My hand helps. Yeah, and this is just so beautiful to me. I left a long string because I'm thinking about adding a pom-pom. I don't know. I kind of want it to be a hat for me, and I'm not exactly a pom-pom kind of guy. I don't know, but this is so fuzzy, and it's so hot. Even my hand is starting to sweat in here just from a minute of being in there. But...
You could put a pom-pom on it. It could look like a little man bun.
Yeah. Yeah, because that's the look that I like. But this is marled. It's when you combined smaller, thinner yarn. You could go up to 10 different ones. And I watched a fruity knitting episode, this last one, and she talks about marled. They talk to an expert on that, and you can transition from like 10 thin threads, like 9 black and 1 white, and then you transition to 2 white and 8 black, and you keep swapping out, and you can have a smooth, beautiful transition, and you can change colors. You create your own threads and fabric that don't, you know, no one else could make, or you maybe couldn't even recreate. But I feel like there's this.
Is and so for that, you fabric. Use two.
I use these. Yeah.
Yeah, but you use two of the lace weight.
Oh yeah, I doubled
two,
the lace.
Yeah,
weight.
Yeah, doubled the lace weight
with
two.
This. So yeah, I actually could have done two different colors, but I wanted this gold. I thought it would bring
oh yeah
out. So I'm really happy with it. And the reason I wanted to do the hat to begin with was I had originally seen it on the Bearded Pearl, so he did it with I think a green and a really dark color, and it was gorgeous. So I've been thinking about it, and then Curly Seams
or Emma and Tracy
I watched the last episode, and they did a challenge, and I don't know if it's a challenge to them
to themselves,
just between them, because you know they are so funny. They're just it's just fun to watch them. They put me in a good mood. And so they are social distancing, and they're doing Zoom, and they mentioned last time that they might not still be doing, they might be together next time, which will be interesting. But them giving themselves a challenge and them being distant and then being able to see when they come together to do the podcast makes it interesting to me. So I kind of invited myself in to do. I made a comment on their last episode. I don't know if they've seen it, but I said, hey, I hope you don't mind, but I'm doing the hat too. So anyway, Tracy and Emma, here is my hat for that challenge. For the slipped rib hat, and I love it. It might end up with the pom-pom, and I'll show it again quickly if it does. We might have to go back to McKinney Knittery.
We can do that.
So that's
I know where it is now.
So that's my hat.
And then these are my socks that Rusty knit for me using that Regia Perfect sock yarn. That Arne and Carlos designed, been promoting. And so he did these and got those finished up. It's been a couple of weeks now because I did wear them.
It was right after the last episode.
Yeah, right after the last episode,
and I figured,
which was 2 weeks ago.
I figured if I should just do the second one right away or else it would take a while for me to get back to it.
So you'll see me wearing these in the video that we showed earlier of us around McKinney and Bonham. And I even got unsolicited comments from some of the people walking down the sidewalk drinking wine. Oh, I like your socks. And I was like, my husband knit them. See if he'll make you a pair.
No.
No. That's not happening.
No, he won't.
No. Then, okay, so I've been sewing. I have been sewing. If I haven't been knitting as much, I have been finally getting around to getting some sewing done.
Mm-hmm.
And so I remember y'all, I told y'all that I bought a couple of kits for project bags. So that, just to make, so I thought, you know,
pockets.
Having a kit would be easier to start off with, where it's already printed and I just cut it out.
He's got his pockets in here.
Pockets inside here. And I follow the instructions. So it was a good exercise to learn how to use the sewing machine, since I hadn't done that in 30 years. And, you know, and just to...
Got a good box.
Yes, because Rusty helped me.
Well,
yeah, so that
I double checked it and
it turned out well.
Lined it up like it was a piece of origami or something.
I did end up doing a different. I'd had to make a strap out of a different fabric because it was supposed to be the same as this color down here.
The gray.
But I messed that up And so, you know, it's all part of the learning. And so I just said, well, you know what? I'll get some more fabric and make the strap myself. And so actually it's longer than what it was supposed to be. And so it really kind of works out better to be able to carry it. And Rusty actually put a knot in it to make it a little shorter, but yeah, it works pretty good by hanging around your, over your shoulder, around your neck. I've been using
it. We emptied it out so that we could have all our treasures. All our new yarn has been in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then, I guess the last finished object
is my artwork.
Is your artwork. I'm looking at it up there on the wall.
Yeah, we have it over here on the wall. I'm not going to, with our new setup, getting around the table to the other side and picking it up would be too much. And yes. I can just show a little video of it, but I've been working on it for weeks.
Stick a video in of it.
People, I've shown a little bit of the wood. I do a poplar wood structure, and just with my miter saw, I cut the little legs and glue them together and glue this cube network is what I call it structure. And then I map out the image that's going to cover it. And right, this one is just a geometric image, so it looks like I'm following the structure as a guide. So I'm doing triangles over a more complicated surface. I'm kind of simplifying the surface with triangles. So yeah, that's a new piece. I feel like I've already shown it, so I probably don't need to.
Yeah, you've been showing a bit. But you know, that's what we're doing with these episodes, is the progress of your work. Your work's in progress, and so now you're going to show it finished.
Right,
and you're getting started on the next one already. I've been seeing.
Yeah.
There's a part of it sitting right there, which you're getting.
Yeah, and we actually, I must have left it off of here.
Work in progress, but here's one. Oh,
I
don't have it,
but here's one. So I started, and this yarn is from Round Table Yarn. And I use, what I'm doing here is, I've got these big, you buy 4-foot by 8-foot sheets of foam, like at Home Depot or Lowe's or, at least in Texas. Other parts of the country aren't going to have the same
thickness. Exact
stuff.
No.
They might have a white stuff.
In California and Florida, it's white and it's thinner, and it just doesn't have the R rating because they don't need it.
Yeah.
Like we do here in the middle of the country.
Yeah.
Probably the northern states have something really like this too, because you'd want to keep really your houses heated. We want to keep ours air conditioned.
It's really good because you can just cut squares, rectangles, triangles, whatever, and they'll just snap. You just score it and snap it. And then I've got packing tape or storage tape.
Rusty packs his art. He creates his own crates using this stuff.
I use this white stuff. I build lightweight crates. I build inserts in it to kind of suspend pieces. It's a really versatile, useful thing. So I have been using this same little pyramid for 5 years, or at least 3 years. Mm-hmm. And so it has hundreds of holes in it. But so it's really useful if you happen to have this stuff in your hardware store. So anyway, and then stainless steel pins.
Yeah, they're big.
And I block it.
4x8 sheets of foam insulation.
Yeah. And I go to our sink has a hose, and so I just hold it over the sink and spray it, get it totally soaked with the hose, let it drip off, dab it so it's dry, arrange the stitches a little better, and let it dry. And this is how I block a lot of my pieces. So that's a work in progress, and I'll show you some. I've started working on the wood structure, and so I'll start showing that.
We'll be
soon.
Showing that. Yeah.
Yeah, it'll take me a week or so. I need to work quickly.
Yeah. And so, of course, what's always a work in progress is home and the garden. So we have a little video of us working in the garden this past Saturday. We trimmed a rosemary bush. Rusty did that. Rusty cut out 2 cactuses. One was a cow's tongue, that have really long, sharp spines, and then also a little bunny ears cactus that has the mini, little bitty, microscopic, you can't see them, but you'll feel them in your hands forever.
Yeah, they look like they should be soft and fluffy, and they make you want to touch it.
Yeah, don't be like cuddling, like they have little bunny ears, they're just like the way they grow, but yeah, they're deadly.
They're so cute. But
I think I just about have them all out of me now.
Yeah, well, it's really annoying. So, we're going to show you that. And that was all day.
That was all day Sunday. It was nice. It was hot outside, of course.
Yeah.
But when you just dedicate and just say, okay, we just started off outside. We got up and I took a pot of tea out. We sat on the table and I had a pot of tea. We had our breakfast out there and just got acclimated to as the day warmed up. And we just stayed out there all day. And we had plenty of liquids to drink.
Oh, yeah.
It was Sunday. It was not alcoholic on a Sunday.
It had been on a Saturday.
Yeah, but, you know.
Yeah, well, we
have to work the next day.
Outside in the heat.
Right. So.
So, yeah, so we're going to show that. And now there's something, we're at 45 minutes.
Yep.
If anyone is checking, 45 minutes.
Well, and by the time you edit and put everything, it's going to be longer than that.
Our dedicated subscribers are probably going to watch. However, some people might have started tuning out at this point, in spite of these incredible shirts that Hampton surprised me with. This is my favorite shirt.
Uh-huh.
I do like it. I feel like I should be bowling or something.
Right.
Okay, so.
The wardrobe department sends these for us to put on for these shows. We have to dress by what wardrobe tells us to.
Oh, wardrobe sounds very official.
Yeah. Wardrobe. They're off camera. Sorry. No.
Okay. So, I am wanting to talk to about something real quickly, because I am very detail-oriented, if you couldn't tell from my demeanor and my fastidious grooming.
Okay.
Okay,
take it too far.
Yeah.
However,
I'm very detailed about my artwork and a lot of things. And so one thing bugs me. When I am reading a gauge, when you know you're starting a pattern and it says to gauge it, and it says 22 stitches per 4 inches or 22 stitches per 10 centimeters, and I'm thinking, okay, I actually marked it out on a piece of paper, and 10 centimeters is actually 3 7/8. There's an eighth of an inch difference, which in a lot of gauges, that's a full stitch. And so if you're there trying to figure your gauge out and it's like you get 22 3/4 inches, so you make it 22, when actually it's barely under 21. So, and if you're going to add that up over the equivalent of the round of a sweater, that you might be having an inch or two. So, anyway, I don't know if you should, in patterns, like if it's a Rowan one where it's in England, you should assume 10 centimeters, which is 3.875 inches, or 3 7/8 inches.
Right.
So, anyway, that might be something if someone's on the edge of trying to decide which way to go on their stitches. If you're doing 4 inches, you might want to go down a stitch. So that's something I've been thinking about lately, because I'm about to knit you a sweater.
All right.
After my shows, but then.
Yeah.
And then I was showing Hampton this, and when I have all these skeins, all my stash, and now it's all in Ziploc bags so that they can go through the freezer and all that. But I have this pencil here, so I don't know the gauge. I lose track of the tags and what the WPI, wraps per inch, or what the weight of the yarn is and all that. So I have a pencil, a drawing pencil, it doesn't matter. It could be anything. It could be a dowel, really thick. The thickness doesn't matter. And then I have tape spaced an inch apart, and I've wound it up 10 or 15 times so I get some thickness. I have edges here. And then I take my skein of yarn out, or my little ball of yarn, and I start wrapping gently. And sure, you can push them really tight and get lots of wraps, but you can just so they're touching. And you wrap, and when you get to the end of the inch, count your wraps, and that's how many wraps per inch. And okay. So if you have this ball of yarn and you're trying to coordinate different colors, you just check the wraps. And then I've been writing the number of wraps on the bag so that when I'm trying to sort through for all DK, and DK is 8-ply, and it has its weight 3. I don't know what that classification is, but it's 11 wraps per inch. So I've written down, there were a few, I combined a few different charts to make this because they didn't all have certain ones. And so this is how I coordinate my yarns, is by checking what thickness it is. So good. That's what I call nitpicky, because I'm getting really
nitpicky
detailed about things,
right? But,
okay,
yep.
So moving on
to comments and feedback.
Yes.
So we were talking to Denise and Heather at DMH Yarn and Fiber, and we were talking about moth infestation.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because it turns out we're not able to buy a new chest freezer because they're not available for sale in this country, it doesn't seem. Best Buy said, we don't have any. We don't know when we're going to get any.
Yeah, I said, can I order one? They said, if you don't care what you get, because you can't order a specific thing. We don't know what we're going to get, and we don't know when we're getting anything.
And Lowe's and Home Depot said the exact same thing.
And I said, are there other stores? Can you check? He said, no, we're sold out of the entire store everywhere.
Yeah, all across the country.
So that was my hope, to because I can put little pieces. I can put skeins and individual little things in our freezer.
But I have to put meat and stuff in the freezer. It's we have to have food to eat.
And popsicles.
It's hot. And some ice cream sometimes.
If anyone has not tried Outshine popsicles, those are so intensely flavored. Pomegranate and grape and raspberry are awesome.
Lime and lemon.
Yeah, a couple of the flavors aren't good.
We don't care for the pineapple. And the peach didn't meet my expectations.
They don't have as intense of flavors, but those other ones. And
then there's a watermelon. I haven't tried that one.
Yeah. I don't imagine it would be as intense as...
Probably not.
Those other...
So anyway, so they were saying, Denise and Heather were saying, one thing she said was to wash everything with a water and vinegar solution.
Yeah, all the walls in the entire place.
Oh, yeah.
And if you could see a walkthrough, which maybe you will someday, of this entire place, there's 17-foot ceilings, which are more of a finished-off... I mean, it's not a garage at all, but it's a huge unfinished space. Oh, and
it's an old warehouse.
It's an old warehouse, and some areas are really fixed up nice, and it would be almost impossible. Plus, I'm afraid of heights enough. I don't want to get up at 17 feet and... be trying to vinegar water that insulated spray insulation.
Well, I don't think that spray foam insulation on the ceiling in your studio would wash up anyway.
I don't really. Either. It's basically impossible. And like the wall behind us, the plywood, and
we didn't.
That might be a bit much.
That might be a bit much.
However, we're going to put moth traps everywhere.
I don't want it to smell like we're living in a jar of pickles either.
Uh-uh. No, I like the idea of lavender and cedar. And, you know, a number of people have told us that. Great right. Scott Knitting told us that. We kind of knew it, but I had heard that it wasn't effective. But
Well, we're going to try because I bought some moth traps and some lavender sachets, and they should be delivered on Friday.
Yeah. Okay. Well, good, because I
Amazon,
want...
Amazon, take me away.
I don't see as many moths. I don't think it's as big of a problem as it was when I was having all my yarn out. But I missed the days of having my yarn sitting around. We come home from the yarn store with five new skeins, and I want it to sit there as a pile. And we do, as we look at it that night, but then it has to go away. I have to find Ziploc bags and put it away. So
put that away.
So yep. Did she had more suggestions, actually, which then she suggested something called Zap Bug, ZAPPBUG oven 2. And it's this thing, it looks like a huge suitcase that with a pipe coming in and going out, almost like it's, and you know, a movable air conditioner will have an exhaust pipe, and it has one coming in and out, and it's a heater, it's an oven, and whatever you put in there is going to kill the moths at different every period of life, eggs or larvae. I think there's a couple other nymphs, or I don't know.
Good, that's fine.
Yeah. So the thing is, it's like almost $400,
And where are you going to put it? You just have to find some more room.
Well,
in the
it
studio.
Looks collapsible. It looks like it's out of a satin, like a maybe a collapsible suitcase. I would have to look, but I'm going to try everything else. We just
try everything
because,
else
because, well, they need to get out of here. So thank you, Heather and Denise, for that information, and for Hampton's new crown.
Yes. I'll put that on in a little bit and you can splice it in, and
that has been in the dead center of our living room. Well, Lucy, you are losing it. Come on now, walk down the stairs.
I don't think I can walk.
That is some crown.
I don't know why.
It's so sparkly.
Yes.
We've even tried, we've been to Michael's once trying to replace a Swarovski jewel. There's one missing that they had pointed out to us. But
right. They bought a whole stash of used crowns.
Right. And they were, as soon as we walked in, we didn't think they even would recognize us. We've been there one other time. I've talked to her on an email, and they're really nice. But I didn't think they would recognize us with the masks. And as soon as we walked in, oh, Simba.
Ah, hey, Simba.
As soon as we walked in, it's like, oh, I have your crown over here.
Right. Are you here to get the crown?
Yes.
Of course I am.
And I'm here for my popcorn yarn, please. So that was nice.
Yeah.
And a number of people liked the Sweet Tooth Hotel.
That was really cool. I'm glad I went.
Yeah.
I'm glad I went. I got that footage, and whenever they change it out, I'll go back and see what they done next.
Is it always fiber?
That's what they said.
Oh.
And they said they change it out several times a year. I don't know if it's every 3 months or...
That's a huge exhibit.
It is. So
I don't know if...
It's been there 3 years and we didn't know about it.
I don't know if other podcasters have run into this, but just I'll insert this quickly. We used the sound from the videos that they were playing, Justin Bieber and something else, Ed Sheeran, I don't know, some
big
name.
It was one of those songs.
In the background, and I guess instantly when I posted it, someone saw it within 5 seconds. I'm like, wow. Except,
no, I think the YouTube robots. They
oh,
know
I know. I figured it out. That it wasn't a human. There's no way it could have. But instantly, there was copyright infringement. And it scared me at first. But the choice was to either mute that section or, I think their service deletes it. They would crop out that section or they'll delete the music. Or you can't monetize it. And so we have not monetized. So.
We're not making money off of this.
Yeah. We probably won't usually have video with other people's music, but
Now we're going to try not to. And you've been trying not to do that for these podcasts. That's why you've been playing the piano.
Yeah.
And now you have found some free, copyright-free music that you're going to start using.
Yeah.
But there for summertime, I mean, this was summertime, so you needed to play summertime.
Yeah. I learned your mom loved it. I learned it a year ago. My mom passed away a year ago. I was talking to Susanna about her mom, too. And for my mom's memorial service, I tried to learn Summertime. I didn't do the best. No one cared, but I was Mr. trying to be perfect here, could not do it. It was frustrating playing a keyboard that the pedal doesn't respond, and so I had a hard time.
It was at the funeral home, and it was just an electric keyboard. It just doesn't sound like a piano.
Yeah, that was a little embarrassing.
Yeah,
but you know, you just got to roll with it.
Plus, she didn't have time to practice. We just showed up for the service. It was a memorial service.
Yeah, a week ahead, I thought, oh, I can learn this piece. And it turned out to be a little more complicated. Yeah. But
your mom passed last June 2019, and then the memorial service was in August.
Right, and I didn't decide until a week before we were going that I was gonna summertime, because my mom was a singer in our she graduated
community theater.
Yeah, she went to school, she was in education, she is a teacher, but also in voice, and she had a gorgeous voice.
She did.
And so one of the songs that she used to audition with is Summertime, and she did such a nice job of that, so I wanted to play it for her.
Right.
And I wish I had played it better.
Yeah.
So I came home after the service, and then I learned a little bit better how to play it, and then I recorded it. So you're hearing a recording from last year.
And Oregon, it was, you know, since we had to go to a memorial service anyway, going to Oregon in August, getting out of the Texas heat in August, was that part was a delight. I loved that part.
Yeah, it's nice going to Oregon, except in the summer.
Yeah, I wish we could live in Oregon in the summertime.
Yeah. I mean, it gets hot there, too. It gets into the hundreds, but it still cools down at night. And so that it's...
Yeah, but it doesn't stay in the hundreds.
Right, it doesn't stay in the hundreds, and it cools down at night so that you can at least open your windows. Or in Texas, we're... not getting down even below 80s or
at night
or 90s. I don't know where
it's been about 84 when I get up at 5 in the morning.
Yeah. And we're already acclimated, so that actually feels good when we step outside. Yeah. Oh, quick, let's pretend that it's the afternoon. Let's come sit outside and lounge around because it feels so nice.
I'm thinking about having tea in the morning on the patio and having my breakfast on the patio in the morning. Yeah, why not?
Yeah, it's only going to last another month or so. And
right, but this week is going to be in the hundreds.
Yep.
So, let's see. And we do want to thank Kitten...
Waw.
Kitten Waw, which...
W-A-W.
He explained it to us. It stands for whiplash.
With a whiplash.
With a whiplash. With a whiplash.
W-A-W is with a whiplash.
With his tribute to Anne Margaret.
Yeah, and yes. I don't entirely understand that, although I really like Anne Margaret. My main, and I know she was like a bombshell, just hugely popular. I'm this
hugely.
Well, hugely. I didn't used to say that word. Oh, but I remember Anne Margaret on the Flintstones.
Yes,
and she was Anne Margrock.
Right. So. There's that, yes.
So that was thank you, Kitten. And Kitten is a man. Did you say that?
Yes, well, he is. So good.
So thank you, Kitten.
Sorry if we called you a she in last episode.
I imagine he has
just
a sense
pronouns.
Of humor.
Just pronouns. Call me whatever. Call me whatever. Just call me.
Yeah. What's your pronoun? I was asked that lately.
I'll take all of them. Whatever.
Okay. And Susanna? Warner asked about my Entrelac hat, which we were both working on for the Sweet Tea 2020 Knit Along, KAL. And I did finish it. I think I've shown it, but here is my hat, and I'll even put it on. It's a bit, it doesn't really go with this shirt. I don't know what shirt it would go with. But, no,
but I bet I could find one. I'll buy you one.
I'll show that. You'll buy me a shirt. Yeah,
I will. I'll find a shirt to go with it.
Some theme shirt.
I mean,
for the next theme.
The wardrobe department will find you a shirt. That's what I meant to say.
I like the inside. It looked that tessellated kind of. So, that's my hat. I love it, but I am not sure when I will ever be able to wear it. I will have to find the perfect person that might wear it. I am proud of it. It's my first piece of Entrelac that I finished.
It's really cool.
Yeah. So, yeah. I finished mine. So, then also... we got some response to the both Valentina and Heather Kelly and Denise all had some input about spinning dog fur or dog hair. And I actually looked up what's the difference between dog fur and dog hair, or which
is it?
And apparently dogs with two coats, like hunting dogs, some larger dogs, have an inside fur. And when they have two layers of hair, it becomes fur. And when it's a single layer of hair, it's a hair, like a poodle has hair.
Oh, I see.
And some dogs have fur. And so it is both. And I showed pictures of my dentist and her dog, Max, the giant poodle.
Yep, Dr. Carol M. Boyd.
Mm-hmm.
We love her.
And so
I saw her last Thursday.
Yeah.
And I let her know that you're getting some leads on having Max's hair.
And then she said, okay, so I'm all gung-ho on finding some information. And she said, well, it might be 6 years.
Right. She's going to wait till Max leaves this mortal coil.
Well, I'm glad she...
She's collecting all the hair from all of his haircuts. And then she wants an Afghan made out of it. So
someone said that we might check on Etsy. I think Denise gave me the name of Mary someone. If it's a helpful resource for someone, if anyone else is interested, I'll check if I can pass on her email too.
Yeah.
I haven't even checked with her yet, so.
Right.
That'll take a little bit. Then you got some, Diana Thorpe talked about using fabrics.
Oh yeah, Diana Thorpe, she did give me some advice about not mixing new and old fabric because the old is going to wear out faster than new fabric.
Right.
Which makes sense. I mean, because it's already wearing out. Like that shirt that I really love is already 25 years old anyway. But, you know, I only really wore it once a year around Thanksgiving. So it wasn't that bad. But the buttonholes were starting to get messed up. And then she's also the one that mentioned using the white paper behind things on this filming so it would stay focused.
And, you know, some people have overhead cameras, and I imagine this might be a light enough, neutral enough surface. Maybe this would function if we get a camera that can look down.
Yeah.
So that might be something coming
out.
More equipment. Yeah, we still are working on... Did we tell people about our microphone? We're still working on the clip-on microphones. I have to call the company and figure that out.
I bought them.
But we talked about this microphone, didn't we?
No, we haven't really talked about it.
So we have been going for...
You said you figured it out at the beginning of this.
Yeah, so we've had this big blue Yeti Nano.
We've been going for 6 episodes.
For 6 episodes and in all our Zoom meetings.
Yeah.
There too. For months... And then last episode, Hampton tried talking like this,
And it didn't do anything.
It didn't do anything. And finally, because, I thought, wait, we're going to test this.
Because this wasn't working at all.
We had it plugged in. It's just for show. Right. For the last few episodes. But it's
entertaining us.
It's working this time. I actually went into my settings and found it. And
yeah.
It wouldn't become the default for a little bit. But I tried a couple times. Go. And now we have good sound that actually will react to how close we get.
Good.
And that is awesome.
Excellent.
Okay.
Well, that's about everything. No,
that is good. That is good. And
that's about everything we had to talk about today.
Right. Right. So I am still going to play pieces of music. And when I do, I'll put them at the end. But we are having the new non-copyrighted music.
Right.
That we found that after this episode, I'll start using that music.
Actually, I think you've started using it in this episode.
Yeah, I plan
for
to
some
use
of
it.
The video clips that we've stuck in here. So
yeah. It's a duet. It's something that I can picture, even though Hampton doesn't play an instrument, I can picture us doing it because
and
it's
not
a duet.
Learn either.
So anyway, I hope you like the music because I'm thinking of making it the theme music.
Right.
Even though I will take the opportunity to play every now and then because I like playing
but
you know,
thanks for watching our 7th episode, Joel, and subscribe, tell your friends,
click on the notifications
and send us comments and questions, and we'll see what we can do about answering those.
Yeah,
we're gonna do our best. All right. Bye. Thanks, y'all.
Bye.